Let's now talk to Carlos Conde. He's the Philippine researcher for Human Rights Watch's Asia Division. Carlos, thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Carmina, for having me.
Nice to see you again. Now, with 80 of the suspects in the Maguindanao massacre case still at large, tell us, what potential danger does this bring to the victims' families?
Oh, there's a very, very potential for grave danger, not only the families of the victims, but also the witnesses during the trial. Because keep in mind, dozens of these suspects who are still at large, some of them work as close in security for the Ampatuans. Several of them were police officers and soldiers. So they are in a position really to intimidate, to threaten, even to harm the victims' families and the witnesses. So as long as they're out there, and especially if the verdict turns out to be guilty, I don't want to say this, but we can expect some retaliation from them. And that's something that we don't want to see in Maguindanao happening.
And we don't want to see that culture of impunity persisting once again. I mean, will it ever end with these suspects still at large, Carlos?
Oh yeah, I mean it's with these suspects at large, it only underscores the need to end impunity and also for the government to really take this matter seriously and do whatever they have to do to arrest these people. As far as we know, they're still out there in Maguindanao, in Mindanao, hiding in strongholds of the Ampatuans. So, it will take it will take some political will on the part of government to really arrest them. And really, in the final analysis, Carmina, this case, regardless of how this will end up, as long as it is determined that the process, due process, has been followed, this will have an impact on the justice system in the Philippines. And more, pessimistically, if the suspects will be acquitted, then that would really, prolong impunity in the Philippines, and that would be a really huge setback for the cause of human rights and justice.
We're going to talk about Judgment Day in a bit, but first, Carlos, we have to talk about how it got to that point to begin with. Why was there a need to murder more than 50 people? And why was there just an absence of respect for life? What is the assessment of Human Rights Watch and as to what happened during that day?
Well, we put out a report in 2010 about the Maguindanao massacre, and we determined that the violent, the corrupt political culture in that part of the Philippines is mainly to blame for what happened. I mean, they had thorough control of the province, some sections of the region, and they felt that they could get away with anything, including mass murder. And that the fact alone that it took quite a bit of them to carry out the murder, the massacre, and just pull out, pull over many dozens of these people in the middle of the highway without regard for consequences, tells you that these people, the Ampatuans and the suspects behind this massacre, have always been enabled by the political culture in Mindanao. So that's in a nutshell is the cause of all of this.
And a decade since, Carlos, how have things changed?
Well, I'm sorry to say, but things have not changed quite dramatically. Not in Maguindanao, not in Mindanao, and certainly not in the whole country, where a lot of these political fiefdoms, a lot of these political warlords still govern, using force, using guns, using violence, using money. So what we're hoping to happen is that a guilty verdict on the Ampatuan would send a really strong signal to political leaders, to political warlords, and all of these political dynasties around the country that, look, you cannot get away with murder that easily. So they have to contend with rule of law.
We're less than 24 hours away from the verdict. Let's set our sights on that now, Carlos. You have more than 100 accused, and there were reports as well of money flowing to bribe witnesses and even victims' families throughout the course of the trial. What are we going to see tomorrow? Tell us your expectations.
Well, it's just, in this case, where close to 200 are respondents, and 107 are in custody right now. You can imagine that a lot of witnesses, a lot of testimonies were presented in court, and there have been many of those, very incriminating testimonies. Like, for instance, Maguindanao, the backhoe operator, provided really, strong testimony. So, I mean, from our perspective, as a rights advocate, and from the perspective of the families that we spoke to, they don't see any reason why the Ampatuans or the respondents, the suspects, would be exonerated by this. There's just too much evidence and witnesses that they are they're kind of hopeful that they will be found guilty. But at the same time, this is the Philippines where anything can happen. Mm. So there's still that, trepidation, to be honest. And so, but really, if the suspects are found guilty, we can expect a flurry. The Supreme Court will be inundated with appeals, and that's also one of the proposals that the lawyers of the families and even Human Rights Watch is supporting, which is for the Supreme Court to designate a special division to handle the appeals. Because if they don't, then the search for justice will just be prolonged and continue.
Yeah. Continue. Which brings us to our final question. What do you think, Carlos? Is tomorrow going to be the end of that quest for justice?
Well, yeah, I mean, it all depends on how the Supreme Court will handle the appeal if they're found guilty. And obviously, the Ampatuans, they will also try their best to try to deflect or to try to appeal or to try to overturn the judge's ruling. But we are confident, again, as I mentioned earlier, we are confident that because of the sheer amount of testimony and witnesses that have been presented, that there's no way the court can acquit. But as I keep saying, this is the Philippines, so we never know. We're praying that justice will be served, and finally that the lesson of this massacre will be learned by not just by the public, but also by our political leaders.
Carlos Conde, Philippine researcher for Human Rights Watch's Asia Division, thank you so much for taking our Skype call. We appreciate you joining us this noon. Thanks again.